Hello, my friends. I'm International Master Andreas Dzernadianos, and today we'll see the second part of this video series. What is about? It is about the percentage of the bad pieces. Hello, my friends. Today we'll speak about the percentage of the bad pieces. What is this? If your opponent has one bad piece out of five, his percentage is 20%. Okay, it's 20. So if I exchange one or two pieces and he has one piece out of two, then he has 50% bad pieces. So this is a very well-known technique that in order to win a position that your opponent has a bad pieces, you have to exchange his good piece. Okay? So let's start with a very good example about this. In this game, white is Karpov and black is Lotje. This game was played in Bill 1992. So Karpov start with d4. Okay. d5. c4. c6. Is love? No, because after knight c3, knight f6 and e3, we have e6, knight f3, knight d7, this emeran. Now Karpov played this queen c2 variation, which is very good variation for white. Bishop d6 was played by Lotje, and now Karpov put his bishop on e2. Why he put his bishop on e2 and not on d3? Okay, it seems better because there is this diagonal, this pressure on h7 after black make castle. So why Karpov did not choose to put the bishop on d3? In many openings after d4, d5, white put his bishop on e2. The idea is that after castle, they want to use the d line. A rook on the d line has x-ray on the black queen. So it is not easy for black to organize a pawn break on the center, c5 or e5. Also, white's main idea is to play e4. After the exchange on e4, d takes e4, knight takes e4, knight takes e4, white wants to take with the queen on e4 and after to put the bishop on e4. Because the queen, it will be easy to go to the king side to help for white's attack. So, bishop e2 was played, castle, castle, rook e8, rook d1, as we said before. Of course, black moved the queen out of the rook d1 x-ray, and now a new move. Now, b3 was played a lot of times. The idea is obviously to take on c4 with a pawn, a very good variation also, but Karpov, for this time 1992, he played a new move, h3. This is a very interesting semi-waiting move because black has to develop his bad pieces, this c8 bishop. So white wait because he wants to play e4 after black played d6. Also, when the position will be opened, the h3 will be a very useful move. Also, in some ideas that black wants to play something like take on c4 and e5. Okay, just take here and play e5 and e4. Then this square is very well protected, not to have some ideas of attack. And black play b6, of course, to solve this problem of the bishop. And now, of course, white is consistent with his plan and played e4. D takes e4, knight takes e4. Queen takes e4, bishop b7. Now bishop g5 doesn't do anything because after bishop g5, knight f6, queen h4 is nothing because this endgame is quite okay for black. They have some damaged pawn structure, but after c5, his two bishop will be give him good counter chances. So after knight f6, bishop take on f6, queen take on f6, knight e5, rook c8 with the idea of rook c7 and c5. The idea of rook c7 is just to protect this bishop and black will be fine. So Harp of play, very good idea. Exchange black's good bishop. This is a good bishop because the pawns are on light square. So light square and dark square bishop control very well the center. So if I exchange this black bishop, then white will have some control over dark squares, like this position. After bishop c4, it's not easy to find an easy way out for black. After c5, the best move is not to take this, because in this position, the opposite color bishop gives some chances to black. This is a very well-known pawn structure, with 3 versus 2 on the queen side, white, and black has 4 versus 3 on the king side. Enter. What matters in this pawn structure is the D line, because it's the only open file, okay, and the control of the E5 square. Because if black has the control of the E5 square, like in this position, they can put forward his majority with E5 and F5. So for example, rook d4, e5, black has counter jump. So it's better after c5 for white to take on d6. Now, black take on e4, take on e7, d take on c5, and b4. Knight a4, and rook c1. This obviously is better for white. Have the d-line, they can mobilize this own majority with c5. Also, the knight on a4 has to be very careful, okay? So it is the good way for white to continue. So c5 was not played. If black take on a4, then the problem is that after c5, the queen can come to c7. And this exchange, we take on c5 and knight e5. This is slightly in white's favor. Although black has this pawn that stopped is the pawn majority of white, because this c5 pawn is not on b6, so it is on c5. It is not easy for white to mobilize his queen side majority. This pawn also is weak, okay? So white has the advantage. That's why Lottier played rook a8, and now knight e5 doesn't do anything, because knight f6, the queen protects the bishop on b7, and c5 equalizes the position. So white has to be consistent. He has to exchange this bishop and then put the knight on e5. Now, if black played something like knight f6, queen e3 and c5, of course we exchange queen, and very good move. This f3, okay, obstruct 2 black pieces. The knight on f6 has no the e4 square, not the d5 square also, and the bishop has no this diagonal. So white has a very easy advantage, because the king can come to e3. Also, there are some ideas with g4 later on, okay? So white has a stable, small advantage. That's why after knight e5, Lottier took on e5. I took the pawn, because now have a outpost on d6. Queen c7. Black obviously want to play d5. Bishop f3 and bishop a8. I think this is the most critical point. Pause the video, my friends, and start to think how to continue with white. It's not easy to prove the advantage. Black has a bad piece, bishop on a8, out of 4 pieces, because the king also is not playing here, we cannot count it. So it is 25%. But Karpov make a very good decision. The queen h4 is not so good, because not rook e7, because white can take on d8 and take the d-line, of course. Also, the exchange on d1 in this position is not so good, because white take the rook. And now if black take the e5 pawn, then not rook d7, that was Karpov analysis, because now with the computers we can understand better these positions. because this queen e1 is very good and is not easy for white to make progress. Okay, black seems fine, but the good move is to play rook d8. Now, after king f8, take on e8 and take on h7, this is better for white. Also, after c5, white is better. But this maybe it is what black has to play. White has to take on a8, exchange the d1 first to exchange one pair of rooks, and then with rook d6, black of course will suffer, but there is no weakness in his camp, so maybe he can keep this position. It's not so much. That's why Karpov make a very good. He start to exchange all the black pieces except the bishop on a8. So what is going up? The percentage of the bad pieces is going up for black. Okay, now it is 1 out of 4, 25%. If I exchange the two rooks, it's 50%. Okay, because the king, we don't count, is not played yet. Cannot participate in the battle yet. Okay, so take on d8, take on rook d1. Okay, now we see this position. Of course, white is better, but there is very interesting that Lothier now has the defile. If white manages to take the defile, it will be very bad also for black. So after queen d8, a very good move, black has some counter chances because they are threatening these two pawns, this or this. Now also g3 has some interest, but I think Karpov chose the best way. Played b3. After b3, black has to take on a2, of course. Now queen d4 is nothing special because queen a3 and black queen can retreat, can come to f8. So after check queen f8 saves black, but also after queen d7, black has check, take the pawn, and queen b8. And also this is not good for white. So Karpov used the time to play b4. Queen a1 check and king h2. White has two ideas now. The first idea is to play b5 and to create fast pawn because of the pin. After b5, white will take on c6. The second idea is to play queen d3. Okay, at an appropriate moment, because now d5 is hanging. So the best move I think now is queen b2 to keep the position. I think this is the best move. And after b5, it's very important not to take this pawn. This is bad. After queen d3, queen c5, and check, black has to go there, and this ending, black has some pawns for the pieces, but is not enough. Okay, we can see that white should win. But the best move after queen b2, b5 is g6. Okay, not to worry about the 8th rank or bank rank mate, and also then to take on f2. Now is not the same. After queen d8, black can take on c6, check, and take this. So I think black has counter chances, and it is about equal. In the game, black played queen a6. And now a very good move. b5 is not good because black protect his back rank, and when white created passed pawn on c6, black can play simply h6, a5. And this pawn also gives counter chances. Okay? So, the best move after queen a6 is queen d4. Queen c8 and c5. The idea is this very good move to take with the queen on c5. Because if you take with the pawn, black will have the a passed pawn. Now, black cannot create a passed pawn. His bishop is passive on a8. Maybe now queen b8 is a move I like very much because he has all these ideas. Protect the bishop, keep the 8th rank, put pressure on e5 and b4, protect the a7. Okay, I think this is the best move, and black has chances to make a draw, good chances. But Lotia played a6, queen e7 and g6. Now h4 was played. It's a very good move. How to react with black in this position? How to make defense? White idea is obviously play h5, h6, or also to break the king. Some idea, sometimes, from to a4, and maybe also to put some threats. Can you find what is the best defensive setup for black? It is h6. Lotier played h5. This is not a good move. After, of course, black can play first queen b8 again, and after h6. After h5, this is a very bad position. This is a very typical theme on the endgame. Okay, all the time in the endgame, you have to analyze with h4 and h5, or without h4, h5, the same ending. These two moves, if they were played, make all the difference. So, now, white play king g3. After queen b8, the king can simply come to f4 now. White has a clear advantage. Queen b7 was played. How to continue? This is a very good point to remember. Okay, think at this moment, and you will remember it for all your game. All of us will just put the queen on f6 or d6 or c5, maybe give some check on d8 to play queen d4. This is quite good moves, but not the best move. If you don't find the idea, then you didn't understand Karpov's idea from the exchange of the rooks. Now he exchanged also the queen. This is a fantastic move for Karpov. Fantastic move. Bishop has to take on b7, and now king e4. Obviously, we play an endgame with all the pawns on the color of his bishop, so all the dark squares are weak. These 2-1 on the queen side pawns are not participated at all, so white wins, like we are playing only on the king side. After king e7, bishop e4, this is the basic plan. White wants to play f3 and g4. If black take on g4, then white take with the pawn, f3 take g4, and create a passed pawn after h5. If after f3 and g4 black does not protect the h5 pawn, then white will take the h5 pawn, and also they will have an h passed pawn. This position is lost now. Bishop a8, f3. Now, ideas, sacrifice a piece with c5 doesn't do anything. Bishop take a5, bishop c6, and these two pawns will be blocked, okay, from this square, and white wins on the other side with this idea. That's why Lotia played 7, g4, bishop a8, take, take. Now, don't give anything to your opponent. If you take on a5, black can play h5, f5. Now, the problem is if the bishop moves, black has something like c5 ideas. If I take, then the king cannot come easy to g6. Okay, there is no reason to do this. See how Karpov has all the time to do what he's thinking. He plays first f4. Okay, then moves the bishop back, not to have any tempo, because we don't have this f5 tempo, because now we take, and if you move a5, I have the time to put the king on g6. Lotier didn't see any way to continue this, and he resigned. One of the most good games of Karpov, most technical games about bad pieces. Exchange all the good pieces of your opponent, and in the end game you see this poor bad bishop Okay. The second game is a game from the internet. Maybe this is a blitz, I don't know. White is playing Tanigin, is 2100 player, and black is Zaitsev, Mikhail, 2400. Okay, it is from Ilyuginov Cup from 2006. It is a very good way to show you how, in a very quick game, you can do these exchanges of the good pieces and your opponent will stay with the bad one. So after e4, c5, c3, knight f6. It is an Alapni variation that I played all my life. Knight c3, bishop c4. Okay, this is not important, the first moves, not important at all. And now knight c3, castle, and we have this position. This is a mistake I also made once. Okay. The good idea is to take on e6 immediately. Okay, I will understand why in a few moments. So after bishop e3, queen d7, now white took on e6. Of course, the best way now is to take with the queen, but of course, white has a very good position. And black take with the pawn on e6. Now, this is a very well-known theme of the bad pieces. Can you find which one is the bad pieces? The bad piece is the bishop on d7. This is the bad piece because he cannot participate in the battle. f6 is not possible, and also this bishop cannot go to the other side of the board. He cannot come to the side because of this e7 pawn. The best idea is to isolate this bishop and not to allow black to make pawn breaks based on g5 at an appropriate moment. So after f4, rook c8 and h4 is a very good theme to understand. The bishop will not play. Now, this is a model example how to play. White played very well. Just exchange everything. Okay. Think also that white has a rating of 2100 and black has a rating of 2400. And black lose without doing anything. So, let's continue. See, white can allow black to take the bishop or to exchange everything. Take immediately. One, exchange rooks, the h file. g3, not to have anything there. And b3, please exchange everything. Knight a4. Now, of course, this is a very good move. Maybe it's a better move. But this is the simplest move. Take a queen. If you go to the 7th rank, this is quite okay. If you put the pawn from e7 to f7, maybe black can be fine, of course. But now, it's just lost. Black is playing with a bit less. Take king g2, knight c5, and also, it's not good to take the e6 pawn. If I take the e6 pawn, this is not good, because then black will move the rook, and after some moves, okay, black will put the king, play e6, and this bishop will come to play, okay, from this diagonal. So take the b7, and black will be lost. That's why black didn't play queen g2. Bishop g7, king g2, b6, rook f2, and after a6, very good technique, double attack from the queen. g5 was played. Take everything not to allow this bishop to play. This is all the meaning of the position, of course. Rook f8 was played. What to play now? Of course, exchange everything. Black has 50% bad pieces now. Please exchange the queen. Oh, I don't want to. Okay, king f2 to protect everything. Queen c2, not to allow the king to come. Queen b4. Queen c3, queen a3, okay. Some more moves because maybe it is time pressure, we don't know. To take some seconds for every move if it is a blitz. And now a very good idea. How White transformed his advantage to a winning position. Check and exchange queen. Give everything. This pawn is not important. This knight will take all these pawns. One after the other. We'll see. King f5, king d3, b5, knight c5. Give the pawn, now take e6. The bishop not playing. Knight c7. Take d5. And now go to take the other pawn. 5. If you exchange, you are losing very easily this pawn endgame. So, king e5, d7. See, white took all these pawns. Also, you cannot take because a4. See, he has the idea that the pawn will promote with check, and he like wants his king to go to b8, but after king c5, everything is in simile. So, bishop e7, knight c6, and white just. Okay, not important. So my friends, that's just for today. Okay, always do think about the percentage of the bad piece. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and also see that you can donate through PayPal. Okay, thank you very much.